Hello guys, welcome back. Now here in this session again, down payment itself. So in previous session, what I have covered, guys. In previous session, we have seen the configuration part. So this time, like testing in the sense like end user part. So first of all, we have to post a down payment. We have to post a down payment, guys. How to post a down payment? Look at here. Now, so the configuration steps are already done. Creation of down payment reconciliation account and then assignment with the assignment of this down payment reconciliation account with the vendor reconciliation account. These two activity we have already done. Now, here, if you talk about like end user part. So let's suppose if the Tata Motor is going to place an order worth of let's suppose like any quantity, 1000 quantity, 100 quantity, 100 units, 1000 units of whatever the raw material is there. It could be units or else it could be in terms or you know the unit of measure could be anything, right? So now here 1000 units of raw materials are going to be or what to say goods is going to be ordered by Tata Motor. So when we say let's suppose so there'll be a particular price of that goods whatever is the order is going to be placed by Tata Motor. Say for example the price is 1000. So here vendor will say that okay, in that like what you have to do, so you have to do one thing. You have 20% is going to be 20% is going to be paid in the form of down payment, advance payment. So what we have to do, or else like let's suppose 30%, 40%, whatever amount is there is supposed to be paid in the form of down payment. 10%, it could be it depends upon like negotiations with the vendor. So say for example, I'll just do one thing, guys. Okay, these things already I have explained, right? Now let's suppose, so we are going to place an order worth of 5000, right? And if 10% is the down payment, so 500 we have to make payment initially, and then vendor is going to send us the goods and invoices, right? So first of all, you have to post down payment. MDS-48. You just do one thing, guys. Use transaction code of MDS-48. Now look at here, MDS-48. Here, what is happening, guys? Whenever we are going to post a down payment is going to be posted against special GL indicator. You have to give your vendor special GL indicator A, and then from which bank account this down payment is going to be made. So 1000 is our GL number. 1000 is our GL number, guys. HDFC Bank GL I have created, right? And how much amount? So 500 is the amount which is going to be paid to the vendor. Now, so here what is happening, guys? Since this transaction is going to be posted against special GL indicator A, so this is a special transaction. This is not a normal transaction, right? In case of, let's suppose, if you post any invoices by using FB60 transaction code, that is called normal transactions, right? And I'll just do one thing. Let me open one more screen. So here, in that case, what is happening, guys? In that case, normal reconciliation, in the sense vendor reconciliation account is going to be triggered by system FB60 here. And okay, so let's suppose here whatever amount we are going to give, and so here in this case, press enter. Just press enter. This 200 down payment is being shown because I have tested actually one. So 200 down payment I have posted. So anyway, now here click on details. Look at here. Normal reconciliation account is going to be triggered by system. Vendor reconciliation account, that is 2000. If you guys are able to remember the very first second session of I think account payable, right? There I have created this reconciliation GL, vendor reconciliation GL. But so when we post a normal invoices, guys, this is a normal transaction. So here in normal invoice, what is happening? Or normal invoice means like whether you post invoice or credit memo, right? In every cases, what is happening, guys? System is going to trigger, or even like normal payment also, system is going to trigger the reconciliation account which we have given in this vendor master, except down payment transaction, because down payment is not a normal transaction, guys. Down payment is special transactions where it is going to be posted. Here also vendor is there. So why not system is triggering this vendor account, vendor reconciliation account directly? No, here a condition supply. Condition supply means it is going to be posted against special GL indicator A. It means system will come to know that yes, this is not a normal transaction, this is special transactions. So here in this case, what is happening guys, system is going to trigger a different account in OBYR setting. We have done this. Look at here, down payment, and here you have to give your TATF account. So now system is going to trigger this account against special GL indicator, and that too against your non-vendor reconciliation account. What is the special GL account which we have linked, or down payment reconciliation account which we have linked? That is 1001. So this is going to trigger. So that this is what you have to say. Like if somebody asks, like, okay, during invoice posting, system is going to trigger reconciliation account, vendor reconciliation account. What about the down payment? During down payment, how system is going to trigger the down payment reconciliation account? So you have to say that down payment is a special transactions which is going to be posted against special GL indicator A. Okay, and against this special GL indicator, down payment reconciliation GL is assigned. So this is why whenever we are going to post a down payment transactions, system is able to understand that this is not a normal transaction, this is a special transactions. So now whatever down payment reconciliation GL is assigned against this special GL indicator A, that is going to be triggered. Whereas if you post a normal invoice, in the sense simple invoice or credit memo or normal payment, that is during that what is happening, system is going to trigger the vendor reconciliation account because that is normal transactions. This is how special if you post a down payment, system is going to trigger what? System is going to trigger special GL account or else like down payment reconciliation account. Why? Based on this special GL indicator A. Now you just press enter and I'm going to post an amount worth of 500, right? You can say down payment. And if you want to simulate to see the accounting entry, look at here, HDFC bank account is going to be credited because payment is going to be made to the vendor and vendor is the receiver. So here this is going to be debited. Save it, control S. This document got posted 1016. And if you want to see now, look at your 1016 document got posted. Where is updated, guys? So now you go to FBL3M. GL 1001 is the reconciliation GL account, right? Down payment reconciliation account. Look at here. Earlier, I have posted one more transaction worth of 200 just for testing purposes. This is our transaction which got updated here. So total down payment 700, right? Now what is happening guys, so you know, just do one thing. Now we'll post a vendor invoice /NFP. What is the document number here? 1016, let's suppose. So here you can give FP once again, and here give the vendor number, then give the invoice and amount 5000. The stock zero, what, 5000, right? If you want to give an so now common payment made, what of 500, and the document number is 2016. If you want to simulate, you can simulate. Look at here, system is saying 700 worth of down payment is there. 500 just now I have posted, and 200 earlier I have posted just for the testing purpose, right? So now just save it. Now what is happening guys, we are going to make payment, in the sense now final payment. So final payment means what guys? Final payment means again multiple invoices will be there guys, right? So out of which I have to select these two invoices only, 5000 and 500, right? So what is the final payment? 4500 we are supposed to make to the payment to the vendor. We are going to make payment how much? /NFTAX 53. So 4500 payment is going to be made. Now here give your bank account. Okay, here we are going to give bank account guys. These things hope you guys are a bit familiar because multiple payment we have made till now, right? So now here give the amount, sorry, give the account That is your bank GL account. And here, how much amount, guys? 4,500. Give your vendor number. But if you give only vendor number and if you press enter, then the down payment. Look at here, guys. Okay, down payment is not going to appear. There might be a question in your mind that down payment is appearing here 500. So guys, this is not down payment. Look at here, this is KZ document type. It means this is credit memo, right? If you come down here also, there is no down payment. Down payment is not appearing. Normal invoices are appearing. That 5,000 payment, sorry, 5,000 WhatsApp invoice we have posted, right? So what is the actual payment, guys? Actual payment is 4,500. So 5,000 worth of invoice is there. This is in minus, and the down payment also supposed to appear. Then only 5,000 minus 500, 4,500 is going to be posted. What to do here? You just click on back button, and again back button again, guys. Okay. So what is happening generally? Exit. Do all the details provide once again quickly. Here vendor number. And here you have to give special GL indicator A. So if you give a special GL indicator A, then what will happen? The system is going to add the special transaction also. Now, if you have a look, then KR, 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 KZ, and you come down. So look at here, this is also appearing. But again, there is a problem, guys. This is appearing. Why? Okay, now this is appearing. Yes, it is correct. There is no problem. Now here, so this is two down payments are appearing. I have to make payment of 4,500 for what, guys? This invoice and this down payment. These two items supposed to be cleared. How? So see, I'm showing multiple line items, guys. This is how you guys are going to be perfect, because multiple line items means we have to select very only two line items, right? So you just do one thing: select all, and then deactivate all. Here and then activate only 500 and then 5,000. So look at here, 5,500. So 4,500. This is what system is assigned. And how much we have entered? We have also entered 4,500. If I'm going to post the payment, these two line items are going to be cleared by system. I'll show you. BL1 transaction mode. FBL1N transaction, and here give your vendor number and special our down payment is going to appear. So look at here, this is what the down payment. So this line item supposed to clear, and this line item supposed to clear, right? So I'll just do one thing: click on document and simulate this. Now there is one more thing here, bank one. Because this much only, whereas vendor is getting 5,000 and again vendor is getting credited with 500. Why not vendor is debited with 4,500 itself, right? I'll tell you guys. Now, because we are having two different line items. This is open item worth of 5,000. This is also open item worth of 5,000, right? So this is a credit. Against this credit, a 5,000 worth of debit got created. So this credit 5,000 and this debit 5,000 is going to nullify, balance will be zero. What about this 500 down payment? This is going to be, this is debit here, this is debit balance here, and credit is here. In this sense, you if you debit and credit, let's suppose you're not able to account finance and account background, you just look at here plus. This is plus positive value, and here it is negative value. Plus minus, it is going to be nullified. Same amount is there, right? It is going to be zero. So this is how it is going to be cleared. And finally, what is happening, guys? Here, this accounting entry is also correct, because 4,500 credit is there. Even debit is also like 4,500 itself. Sorry, look at here. This debit, debit is 5,000, and even credit is also 5,000 only. 500 equals to 5,000, credit equals to 5,000. Okay, now you just post it. So once we post it, these things are going to be cleared. Two line items only, this one and this one. Document number 2011 and 3000, 3003. So refresh, refresh, both line items are gone. Both line items are gone. Now look at here, I have fixed it like earlier. So just I posted, but the payment is not released. I'm having one more invoice where like worth of 1000 rupees. Okay, document number was 2010, and I'm having one more down payment worth of 200. This is document number 1050. So again, if you want to release payment for this one, same. I'll post one more. This time 800 because 200 down payment and 1000 worth of invoice. So remaining 800 payment we are going to make. And here you can give A. So down payment 200 is going to appear. And 2010, this is the invoice, right? So you just do one thing, select all, and again deactivate all. And this I'm going to activate. This 1000 KR means invoice. And if you come down, so this 200, this is our KZ means payment, but this is a down payment, right? So now 800 system is assigned, and we have also entered 800 itself, right? Simulate. Similar accounting entry, guys. This 1000 is with the help of this debit 1000, invoice is going to be clear. This 1000 worth of invoice is going to be this line item is going to be clear. And again, we are having 200 worth of down payment, that is debit, and here 200 worth of again credit line item is there, that is going to clear that down payment, right? And this 800 is like, of course, it is going to be posted in your HDFC bank account because this is what the actual payment we have made. Save it. If you're going to save it, then this line item and this both supposed to be cleared. Both are gone. So this is how what is happening, guys. The down payment is going to be configured and down payment is going to be posted. Very simple topic is there, guys, but sometime what happens, like if the people are started asking questions and all, most of the people are going to be confused. They know how to configure this down payment. They know testing part also. Some of the people will be able to remember transaction code also. But when it comes to the logic, most of the people are going to be failed. They won't be able to explain how system is going to trigger this down payment reconciliation account, or how down payment, how system is going to trigger the normal reconciliation account, right? So that's all in this session, guys.